In this video, we discuss the solution of one-dimensional heat transfer equation. The one-dimensional heat transfer equation is given by dou square u by dou x square is equal to 1 by h into dou u by dou t. By method of separation of variables, we assume that u x t is equal to x of x into t of t is the solution of the given partial differential equation. We require dou square u by dou x square to substitute in equation 1. For that, first let us evaluate dou u by dou x. Then t of t is constant into derivative of x of x with respect to x can be denoted as x dash. Now once again differentiate with respect to x, we get x double dash of x into t of t. Again we require dou u by dou t. Therefore, we differentiate u with respect to t, we get x into t dash. Let us substitute the values of dou square u by dou x square and dou u by dou t in equation 1. We get x double dash of t is equal to 1 by h into x t dash. That is, x double dash by x is equal to 1 by h into t dash by t. Now, the left hand side is purely function of x, and the right hand side is purely function of t. Also in the problem it is clear that x is the distance of a point from the origin and t is the time. They are independent variables. If x and t are independent variables and two expressions in x and t are same, which means that they are equal to a constant. Let us call the constant k, the constant as k. Now this constant can have three different situations. The constant k can be equal to 0, or the constant k can be positive, or the constant k can be negative. Let us discuss them case by case. Let us take case 1, that is when the constant is equal to 0. We consider the first ratio, that is x double dash by x is equal to k. Since we have assumed that k is equal to 0, we will get x double dash divided by x is equal to 0. And a fraction is equal to 0 whenever the numerator is equal to 0. Now, if I write the same in d notation, I can write it as d square x is equal to 0. The auxiliary equation corresponding to this differential equation is given by d square is equal to 0. If I replace d by m, I will get the auxiliary equation as m square is equal to 0. The roots of the auxiliary equation are 0 and 0. They are real and repeating roots. Therefore, the solution of the differential equation is given by c1x plus c2 into e raised to 0x. And it is same as c1 plus c2x. Since c1 and c2 are arbitrary constants, we can exchange them too. Therefore, I can write x of x as c1 plus c2x. Analogously, consider the second fraction, that is t dash divided by ht is equal to 0. And since the fraction is equal to 0, the numerator t dash is equal to 0. If I write it in d notation, I will get derivative of t is equal to 0. The corresponding auxiliary equation is given by d is equal to 0. The roots of the auxiliary equation here, since it is of first order, I have only one root, which is 0. Therefore, the solution of the differential equation is given by t of t is equal to c3 into e raised to 0 t, which is same as c3. Therefore, uxt is given by x of x into t of t equal to c1 plus c2x into c3. Now this solution is independent of time, as there is no t in this expression. Normally a temperature distribution cannot be independent of time, hence we take this solution as we won't take this as a general solution that satisfies the physical conditions. Now take case 2, that is when k is positive. If k is positive, we take k is equal to p square, where p is some positive constant. Let us take the first ratio, that is x double dash by x is equal to p square. Let us simplify the same. X double dash is equal to p square into capital X, which implies that x double dash minus p square x is equal to 0. If I write it in d notation, I will get d square x minus p square x is equal to 0. The auxiliary equation corresponding to this differential equation is given by d square minus p square is equal to 0. If I replace d by m, I will get the auxiliary equation as m square minus p square is equal to 0. The roots of the auxiliary equation are given by m square is equal to p square, that is m is equal to plus or minus p. The corresponding solution of the differential equation is given by c1 e raised to px plus c2 e raised to minus px. Now let us consider the second ratio, that is 1 by h into t dash by t is equal to p square. Cross multiplying by h into t, we get t dash is equal to h into p square into t. Transforming the terms on the right to left, I will get t dash minus h p square t is equal to 0. If I write it in d notation, I will get dt minus h p square t is equal to 0. The auxiliary equation is given by d minus h p square is equal to 0. If I replace d by m, the expression changes to m minus h p square is equal to 0. The root of the auxiliary equation is given by m is equal to h p square. Therefore, the solution of the differential equation is given by t of t is equal to c3 e raised to h p square t. Now let me substitute the value of x and t of t in uxt. Uxt was x of x into t of t, which is given by c1 e raised to px plus c2 e raised to minus px into c3 e raised to h p square t. Again, if we observe this solution, it is a solution that converges to infinity as t tends to infinity. T is the time which lies between 0 and infinity. Therefore, this solution is also not consistent with the physical conditions. Now let us consider case 3, that is when k is negative. If k is negative, we can write k as minus p square, where p square is some positive constant. Let us consider the first ratio, that is x double dash by x is equal to minus p square. X double dash by x is equal to minus p square simplifies that x double dash is equal to minus p square x. Transforming the terms on the right to left, we will get x double dash plus p square x is equal to 0. Writing in d notation, we have d square x plus p square x is equal to 0. The auxiliary equation of the differential equation is d square plus p square is equal to 0. If I replace d by m, the corresponding auxiliary equation is m square is equal to m square plus p square is equal to 0, from which we will get value of m is equal to plus or minus ip, which is complex conjugate roots. Therefore, the solution is given by x of x is equal to e raised to 0 x into c1 cos px plus c2 sin px. Or it can be written as x of x is equal to c1 cos px plus c2 sin px, as e raised to 0x is unity. Now let us consider the second ratio, that is 1 by h into t dash by t is equal to minus p square. If I multiply throughout by h into t, I will get t dash is equal to minus p square h t. Transform the term on the right to left, I will get t dash plus p square h t is equal to 0. Writing in d notation, I will get dt plus p square h t is equal to 0. The auxiliary equation is given by d plus p square h is equal to 0. The roots of the auxiliary equation is d is equal to minus p square h. Therefore, the solution of the differential equation is given by c3 e raised to minus p square h. Now we have the value of x and t of t. Therefore, uxt equal to x into t of t becomes c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into c3 e raised to minus h p square t. Now, if we observe, we can see that as t tending to infinity, the term e raised to minus h p square tends to 0. That is, the temperature is tending to 0. Since the derivation of the heat equation shows that the temperature decreases as time increases, this solution matches with the physical requirement. Therefore, generally we accept the solution uxt is equal to c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into c3 e raised to minus h p square t as the solution of the heat equation. And we can observe that c1 and c3 are arbitrary constants. If I multiply c3 inside the bracket, this term will reduce to c1 c3 cos px plus c2 c3 sin px into e raised to minus h p square t. Since c1 and c3 are arbitrary constants, the product is again going to be an arbitrary constant. Hence, it can be denoted by c1 itself. C2 into c3 is also arbitrary constant. It can also be denoted by c2. Therefore, the general solution is normally written in the form c1 cos px plus c2 sin px into e raised to minus h p square t.